Morning, friends. We got a overcast start. We're just rolling out a designated tent area. We'll be doing a lot of farmland walking today. Had some sad news today. Colonel Bob Watson, guy I met on the trail right after I met Bandit. We stayed in the shelter together. He passed away coming out of Harper's Ferry, apparently. We met him shortly after I met Bandit. We spent first night in the shelter. Our first night in the shelter together. It was thunderstorms that night. Bandit and I said we'd never stay in a shelter. But when the thunder started rolling, we got in there, Bandit, myself, and Colonel Bob. So, prayers out to you, Colonel Bob, and your family. Good thing we're professional stair climbers.
Watch poison oak on the coming out.
Oh yeah, on the right.
On the left right there. Yeah.
Look at that deer. He said, I'm going back in the woods. We got about 7.5 miles knocked out for the day. It's been real muggy. Hadn't been raining yet, but feels like it almost has because some air so damp. But making good time as we expected. Railroad crossing. Probably not. Looks like another low ceiling ahead.
Yep. A dangerous one too. You got that limb hanging down.
Pretty sure we're crossing I-81 here. hiking along with MJ up ahead. He's from Atlanta.
There he goes.
They're getting some people honking horns for us here. We cross over the interstate, but we're having a good hike so far. Just closing in on our 10-mile mark, so almost halfway for the day. Sun's been staying down in the clouds. You see the mountains off in the distance. That's where we're heading. We still got some nice flat ground for probably the rest of the day and a little bit on the start of tomorrow. But once we get through Duncannon, then things will start ratcheting back up to normal. So we'll be climbing again. But yeah, enjoying the hike so far. We thought we'd be going through a lot more farmland, which we were going through farmland, but a lot of it's still in the woods, so not as exposed as we kind of thought it was. But we're out here doing it, southern Pennsylvania. We'll check in a little further down trail. morning, friends. It is about 6 o'clock. Well, actually, good evening, I guess. We held up here at Cove Mountain Shelter. There's a steep walk downhill and a little steeper down for water, but ended up being a smart move because it's raining pretty good right now. And this shelter is battling a critter problem. They got issues with the porcupine. So they've taken a few steps to try to deter the porcupine. They removed the steps from the shelter and they installed this metal flashing here. Supposed to keep them from being able to get his claws up on there. And obviously we're not going to be storing any food, but I think we're going to stay in the shelter tonight, avoid having to set up tents. This one's pretty nice. It's got four bunk beds. So worst part about it is we'll have a haul out in the morning, but we just got about 3 miles to make it on into Duncannon, and we're going narrow from there, so be a good rest day. So, but yeah, we covered about 23 miles today, somewhere thereabouts, and got a little rocky there towards the end, giving us a little preview of what Pennsylvania is going to be like. But most of the hike was very flat, as we expected, kind of through farmlands, but was definitely not as wide open and as exposed as we thought. It was a lot through the woods and a lot of cutting through weeds. So I got my fingers crossed I didn't get into too much poison ivy, but we'll know that shortly here. So, but yeah, that's gonna be probably it for tonight. Got some dinner going and just get settled in, rest up. Look forward to Nero Day tomorrow. Rest up at a hostel there in Duncannon. So we'll see y'all down trail. Thanks a lot for watching and subscribing. Thank y'all for tuning in. We'll see you later. Yeah, definitely we made the right call. We got nice, hard, steady rain. It'd be no fun hiking over all those rocks and this stuff.